Creating sentences from jumbled words. In the previous lecture, which was lecture 1 on sentences, we learned that a sentence is what? It's a group of words which makes complete sense. Right? Now, we will see some words or collection of words which are written in 1, 2, 3. Okay? 1, 2, 3, which are jumbled up. So ideally this is a sentence, okay, but what I have done here is I have jumbled up the words, I have rearranged the words, I have changed the order of the words in such a manner that if you read it now, it does not make a complete sense. So let's see the first one. For example, first one reads as King is lion the jungle off. Can you understand the head and tail of it? No. But here you have to exercise your intellectual skills. How? King is lion, the jungle off. But we know that lion is the king of the jungle. Right? This is what we have been told ever since we were a kid. Right? So how do we rearrange it? We know that lion is the king of the jungle. So we write the word lion. Okay, and as I told you, the first alphabet of the first word of a sentence has to be a capital letter. So even though lion was written as small l here, ideally it should not have been, because even otherwise lion stands with capital L. But this was done deliberately. Lion is the king. Okay, king of what? King of the jungle. Right? Is it making any sense now? It's actually making a complete sense. Why? Because lion, about whom we are talking, this is basically known as the subject. I will come to subject and predicate a little later. Is the king of the jungle. So we are talking about lion, who is the king of the jungle. Let's see the second sentence. Pride, Sachin, nation of the is. Making any sense? Obviously, a big no. No sense. But what we know is that Sachin is being talked about. How is Sachin related to the nation? Sachin is the pride of the nation. Right? So can we try and see whether we have all these words here? So Sachin is the pride of nation. Well, we have all the words here, so we will rewrite it. Sachin. Again, the first word has to be capital. Is. Start ticking as you pick up these words. The. We can't write Sachin is the nation, right? Because our nation comprises of many other people beyond Sachin. The what? Pride. Of nation. So we have used up all the words to write this, and as we had discussed earlier, every sentence ends with a full stop. So once my sentence is complete, I will put in a full stop here. This is what I did here also. After jungle, I had put in a full stop. Right? The third one, again the most simplest of the all. Colors, rainbow has 7. This is again making any sense? The answer is no. So how do we make it the sense out of it? We apply our common sense. How do we apply the common sense? We are talking about what? A rainbow. We are talking about 7. We are talking about colors. And we know very well that rainbow has 7 colors. Right? So we will just rewrite it accordingly. Rainbow, again capital R, has, we stick this word, 7, tick this, colors. Right? We end this with a full stop. Right? So rainbow has 7 colors. So the sentence is complete. It is making a lot of sense. Not lot of, actually complete sense. It has ended with a full stop. It has started with a capital letter. So keep this principle in mind. Whatever book you might be using for your regular curriculum, you can try many more examples from that. With this, we come to the end of this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and help us spread the message by sharing this video amongst your friends through social networks. Thank you for your support and your patience in hearing and listening to lesson. My name is Arinjay Jain and I am your teacher for this particular lesson. Thank you very much.